Hi, I'm Ender or FBI Open Up, and today we will be going over some helpful tips to manage your equipment in the Azurlane Depot. This video will be divided into short tips that will eventually lead to me clearing out a good portion of my depot. As a disclaimer, if the best gear that you have is not gold, obviously do not disassemble the best stuff that you have. Keep the best rarity gear that you have until you get purple or gold gear. Before I get started, this is a great time for me to open some of my gold boxes, since this will give me more items to disassemble come later on in the video. So let's get started. Boom, 10 bang. Let's see if I get some golds. Okay, Steam Catapult's nice. The BTD Destroyer is slightly worse than the Helldiver, but moving on to the Royal Tech Box. Okay, two gold Roombas and a gold Barracuda. That's fantastic. The Sakura Tech ones too. All right, nothing too good. The Belfast gun's very nice though. And finally, Iron Blood. Get some quintuple, no, quadruple magnet torps. Not really. All right, cool. So now when you go to the depot, hopefully now I'm saying it right, where basically all of your items are stored, you will notice that you have 300 open item slots that you can use to hold your gear for your ships. I would not recommend buying extra depot slots through the shop when you click gems and then items. Do not buy this depot expansion because there are a lot of better ways to spend this premium currency, such as expanding your dock, buying some promise rings for your waifus, or of course, the most important part, buying skins. And also, this inventory issue can be solved pretty easily, so as you can see, I'm level 101. And I have never had to expand my depot once. Now, the first and easiest tip that a lot of people overlook is to simply equip your ships with the items from your depot. This may seem obvious at first, but if you do have a ton of extra gear lying around in your depot, like how I do, it is taking up a ton of precious space and it is accomplishing nothing. By putting the equipment on your ship, it removes it from the depot inventory. As you can check, the capacity is 300 right now. And it will remove it and put it on your ship instead. So, as you saw, the capacity was 300, but if I quickly go to my Washington and I equip her with some items that came from my depot storage, the number is now at 295. So, this will be able to save you a ton of room by simply just equipping the guns onto your ship. Now, as another general tip, if we go to the Items tab, this is kind of relating, but do not use your general equipment parts too much on non-gold items because they are basically used for all of your aux items and they will always be in heavy demand. As you can see, I only have 13 purple parts, but I have hundreds of these other ones. Same thing for these blue ones. I have 200 general, but I have at least 1,000 of every other one. So be sure that you are not spending too much of your general parts on other stuff that are not gold, or if you're not going to use later on, because they will be in high demand later on in the game. Now, the second tip is where things start to get a little bit fun. We're gonna go and start disassembling some gear, starting with the gray and blue equipment. So, my general rule of thumb when it comes to this is that you should disassemble all gray and blue gears, but with a couple of exceptions, of course. The first exception is that you do not want to get rid of too many of your fire suppressors or fire extinguishers, because the fire extinguisher is an extremely useful auxiliary gear that can be used for any ship, and you will find it very useful in the later stages when those other enemy ships start lighting your ships on fire. If that does happen, the fire extinguisher is a perfect counter to that, and that will save your ships a lot of damage. Also, the other blue that I want to mention are the fast-firing blue guns, such as the 76mm AA gun and the single 120mm. They are fast firing, and some of them are very, very good on a destroyer, such as Eldridge or Ayanami, who rely on activating their skills or their barrages. So I'd recommend keeping at least one of these 76mm or some fast firing one like the single 120, and keep a couple of these fire suppressors at least. The other blue ones and the gray ones, obviously, you can go and take away. So there we go. I'm going to disassemble that real quick. And now we're left with just these ones. Now the third tip now moves to the purple gear. Once you start being in the middle stages of the game, a majority of your gear will be purple. This means this will also be the item rarity that you will be disassembling the most. Purple gear disassembly follows two questions. The first being, is this the best gear for a ship class or one of their slots? And the other is this item event exclusive that I will not be able to get for a while? If you answered yes to either of these questions, or both of them, keep that purple gear. If you do want a detailed guide of what purple equipment is considered good, check out my equipment guide videos that will showcase what is the best for every ship type for each one of their slots, but I will not be giving a detailed explanation to which one of them they are. Now to start the purple gear disassembly, I'm just going to do a very quick summary of why I'm doing this. So first is the white shell. There's a Cordata version, but it has to be Cordata, so I'd recommend keeping the purple versions. Air radar I don't need since I have the gold prototype one. Fire control radar is useful. Anti-torp is also useful. I have the gold steam catapult thing already, but it's a very good auxiliary for a carrier. SG radar, I have the gold version. It's also a very good one if you don't have the gold yet. This is not good. This is not good. This is an upgraded version of the steam catapult. I am talking a little bit fast, but bear with me or else this video is going to be 20 minutes long. The repair toolkit is pretty good. It is actually arguably one of the best. This is an event, this is a submarine thing, so I'd recommend keeping that. I have gold submarine stuff, so I don't really need that. That gun sucks. Let's see. This is the best, one of the best battleship guns. Same thing with the submarine thing, I don't need it. I have gold anti-air guns. I do not need this plane, even though it is the best fighter for the purples. This is the best dive bomber right here, the Helldiver. This is the not-so-best dive bomber. I don't need this anti-air. This is the best auxiliary for a battleship. Let's go. Okay. Same thing with these. This fairy albacore is from Formidable's event. You do not want to disassemble that. Same thing with this. I have the gold versions of these, so I don't need that. I'm not going to disenchant the stuff that I already upgraded, or else I'm going to be wasting a couple of plates. This is a submarine thing, so I don't need it. Anti-air guns. This is the best purple anti-air gun, so I keep a few of them. Let's keep going. This is actually pretty useful for a couple of ships, such as the IJN cruisers. I have the gold version of this, I have the gold version of this, gold. Actually, these can be used on Graf Zeppelin, so if you do have them, then you might want to use them. I have the gold version of this, so I don't need it, but this purple one you can stick around for a little bit. And that should be all. Now the fourth tip is going to be on the gold equipment, and it is definitely the easiest one to follow. My rule for disassembling gold equipment is don't, unless you have too many of these stupid repair toolkits that plague the gold equipment boxes, because you can always get rid of a couple of them. They're only useful on Akashi and Vestal, so you will not need five of them as I have. So let's like get rid of, I don't know, like three. Goodbye. I hate those. And you also get general parts from them, so they're pretty useful to disassemble. But that's really it. You don't really want to get rid of your gold ones because they're kind of the best in the game aside from those rainbows as a rarity, but you cannot get them from a normal tech box. So yeah. Now with that, I started from a maximum of 300 depot items, and now once I click cancel, you guys can see that my capacity is now only at 247. That means I saved 53 inventory spaces by following these tips, and with that, that will be all for my gear management and disassembly tips. As always, if you found this information helpful, consider dropping a like and subscribing. Don't forget to press the notification bell for my future uploads. Feel free to leave a comment if you have any questions that need to be answered, and I'll try my best to reply. If you have any other video ideas, feel free to leave a suggestion in the comments. And with that being said, that's all I have to say for this video, so see you guys in the next one. Bye!